Should we go talk over here? She can't hear us so easily.
This is not going quite as I hoped it would, Detective.
Lieutenant's voice is hushed. How did you hope it would go? Honestly, I was expecting you to use your unorthodox technique to keep her off balance and, you know, not volunteer us to be her henchmen. Really? I thought it was going so well. This woman is running circles around us. She might have known about your misplaced badge all along, or she's simply an adept improviser. Either way, we've played straight into her hands. Yeah, she's getting us to do our dirty work for her. Or her dirty work for her. Empathy says he doesn't let it show, but there is a limit to how much the consequences of your unprofessional behavior can cost the investigation. Logic says maybe this is all her plan? She might have heard about you. We could just, you know, find my badge. Oh, he nods slowly. That would be fantastic, but do we have the time? The world is large, and your badge is 8 by 6 centimeters. Logic says the situation might have changed drastically by the time you locate it. Time is of the essence. Kim says you could request a new one from your station, but that would literally take months. So what do you propose, that we don't investigate the drug trafficking? No. If there is reasonable suspicion, we must investigate. Otherwise, she could claim that we're siding with the Union, or that we're on the take. We'd never hear the end of it. What I propose is, we ask her, then we investigate. Briefly. He adjusts his glasses. But we do not share the outcome of this investigation with her. We tell her it's done and demand for the information on the lynching. Okay. I am sorry for putting us in this situation. I'll handle it. I'm sure you will, Detective. Let's get back to her then.
You're back. Good. What can I help you with?
She takes a sip from her silvery thermal cup. Yeah, before I get into that, do you know something about these tattoos? That's the man who was killed. She almost takes the photo, but then stops. I'm afraid this is a discussion for once we've cleared the lynching question. So you know something about the tattoos? Better not to tie the forestay to the backstay on this. I hope there's something else I can help you with. Empathy says she wants to answer the question. Protocol keeps her from it. You seem smart. I need someone to give me a lowdown on this reality we're in. This reality? She pulls her hood closer around her neck. I think this is what Kim wanted, but earlier on. Drama says, yes, reality is your side case. Conceptualization says, an experimental side case. It's related to that medical episode. I have trouble remembering even the most basic terms of reality. Ah, yes, the episode. Sounds like an acute case of encephalopathy now that I think of it. She puts down her thermal cup and looks at you. Don't be fazed, madam. He functions perfectly well. He only needs a lowdown on all of reality. We may be here a while, then. She takes a long sip of tea. Ask away, officer. I'll help however I can. Encyclopedia says, all right, we're in. I know these all look good, but begin with the first, okay? Okay. These may get higher. Where are we? We're in Martinez, baby. Baby? A casual term of endearment popular among the 50-plus crowd. It's a disco holdover. Pay it no heed. I'm a disco holdover myself. Ha! She smiles. Aren't we all? Logic says she refers to your corresponding ages. And what is Martinez? Martinez is a district of Revachol. She looks around, her green raincoat flapping in the wind. A very small district tucked away near the industrial harbor, north of the 881 and Jamrock. You would be excused for not knowing about it. Unimportant, they say. forgotten even, shelled to smithereens during the revolution. She shrugs. It has its charms, but not this time of year. Tell me more about Martinese. I'm not a good ambassador. I've only been here once before, as a teenager. Not a lot has changed. Closes her eyes. There are ruins, a terminal, fishing boats, reeds, boys with boxy shoulders. She opens them. This place used to be a province, a workers' resort before the city swallowed it, and the artillery did its work. The reeds are the real star of the show here now. The further down the coast, the wider it gets. You mentioned a sea. What sea is this? It's not really a sea. It's the Bay of Revachol, and the bay feeds into the ocean.
Are we near the ocean?
Yes, we're on an island in an ocean. The world's largest body of water, the Insulindic. Encyclopedia says, known to the early Revacholians as Le Immense Bleu, the Blue Immensities. Inland Empire says, vast, lukewarm, and unknowable, flowing in and out of sight. What's the name of this island? Kelu. She looks to the waters. Imagine a pebble, a smooth over pebble amidst a great blue sea, misshapen, cracked. The cracks are the River Esperance. We're in the delta of this river on the sixth branch, the Martinez distributary. Empathy says, it's clear this pebble is of enormous value to her. Conceptualization says, and to humanity at large. Tell me about another, perhaps even more fundamental aspect of reality. I would be happy to. What is a preposterously expensive education for, if not sharing? Well, wait a second. Okay, that's Martinez. What's Revachol? Revachol. Revachol is what you call a city. What kind of city is it? The great kind. Inland Empire says, as if it's self-explanatory, beyond patriotism, a fact. What makes it great? History, detective. They built this city to resolve history, our part in it, at least our centuries. Our centuries, okay. Okay, who built this city? They built a city on rock and roll, didn't they? Okay. The nations of the Occident, or migrant workers from Seminine and Lilmara, depending on your creed. When was it built? In the DeLorean century, 380 years ago. And why will it resolve history? They say it is where the terrible questions of our time will be answered. The tensions are highest, the fault lines deepest. By that I mean conflicts, ideological conflicts, the stuff of men. Why here? We are standing on a fertile, self-sufficient island able to sustain up to 200 million people in the middle of the Insulindic Ocean, the world's connective tissue. She smiles. It's where the money is. So we're pretty much at the center of the world? Oh, we're quite a way off. About... She points across the water where the skyscrapers rise. 22 kilometers from the center of the world. That soldering iron is the bank of the world building. The bottom floors are Insercom, coalition government, Insulindian mission command. Look to the sea. Silence. She lowers her head. Her hand, rather. Inland Empire says, the water, the light. It's as though you're seeing it for the first time. Shiver says, there is no recognition, only the immensity of the sea and the cold radiating from it. Where are we? Thought gain, jamais vu, derealization. We are where we are. I have no truer answer to give, unfortunately. She watches you closely as you scan the horizon. Inland Empire says, this is one thought you need to complete. Where are you? Was there something else you wanted to know? I remember something about a lowdown. Kim says, this has been informative. Thank you, ma'am. I'm sure my memory-impaired partner has many more questions to ask. He turns to you about even more fundamental aspects of reality. Might I suggest not asking them all right now? Ma'am Messier will be here later, too. or Messia, I think she said, and tomorrow. Isn't that true, ma'am? Absolutely. My commitment here is long term. Yeah, I'll follow his lead. You're right, Lieutenant. I'll continue later. Kim nods. It's better not to eat all your candy at once. Indeed. I'm always at your debt. At your service, sorry. Can I ask a few more? Legendary, what is? Think of something close to you. A fail, wow. It remains a mystery what you mean by this something close. This isn't about you. It's about reality. What times are these? These are unimportant times, Detective. She puts her finger to her lips, then points at you. You and I were born after the dust had settled, a thousandth of a second too late. Too late for what? For the big time. Her eyes light up. There's a flash of teeth. What's the big time? The revolution, she says. Ha! And what is this revolution I keep hearing about? It's quite easy. Every 100 years or so, our species gets together to decide what's next. Who gets shot in the head and who gets the mineral rights? It's called kerfuffle. Would you say it was a bunch of apes duking it out? Why, of course. We're talking Duke Out Central. Full swing intraspecies warfare. And the apes, were they evil? No, I would say the apes were neutral. She looks at you, her gaze sharp. Okay, neutral. On the other hand, she turns north to the bombed out buildings lining the waterfront, then shivers slightly. Rhetoric says, it takes time for the apes to change and work. Perhaps what happened here was part of that time and part of that work. Who got shot in the head? Those would be the communists, generally speaking. 400 million people got shot in the head during the World Revolution. But the communists, they all got shot in the head. Oh, and the anarchists too. They shot them well. So well, one forgets they even existed. Conceptualization says she likes the totality of it. You could say they got totally shot in the head. Indeed, they piled them in mass graves to Ozone and said, and well, that's the last anyone heard of those people. Did the communists and the anarchists shoot back? Did they ever? Before they got shot themselves, they shot 2 million people. Truly a kerfuffle. It was a kerfuffle, all right, the lieutenant mumbles from behind his notes. Yes, the Insulindian deluge, they call it. I had a deluge, too, in my head. Point to your little head. Yes, an accurate thiamine deficiency can be exacerbated by alcoholism. She blinks her green eyes. Exacerbated means made worse. Anyone else get shot in the head on the opposing side? Oh, lots of people. Even the king got shot in the head, or thrown beneath a horse, or drowned. Accounts differ. It was unceremonious, she shakes her head. Just as well, he wasn't actually the king, just the king's nephew. The real king abdicated and lived out a long and productive life as a venture capitalist in Grad. Smart king. Yes, King Guillaume had a nose for bad PR. He ran before it. What's the expression? Went down? Anyway, Gil got out alive and his nephew Frisell got shot in his place. Him and tens of thousands of his wonderfully fascist kingsmen. It was a wild time. When was this kerfuffle? The turn of the century revolution? She smiles mischievously. Don't answer it. It's a trick question. The revolution began in 02 on the Grad Isola, though by the end nearly the whole world had gotten involved. Who started it? It wasn't a who, but a what. A pandemic of Sarath, a particularly virulent prison disease, which the authorities in Grad proved unable to contain. Then Mazov came along and overthrew the government. What did this Sarath do? It made people overthrow their governments. Ah, really? Of course not. It was a highly infectious microorganism that destroyed brain tissue. The actual causes of the revolution were material. The pandemic only provided the spark. Encyclopedia says it was a funny time in history. They discovered transistors and rock music, but they didn't know anything about prisons. Nobody did. Where did it spread from there? From Revachol and Grad? Not far. The world managed to cauterize itself. Mazov's government was overthrown in 08, and the coalition crushed the Revachol commune 2 years later. It was the end. What came next? Why, you and I, officer. She spreads her arms, raincoat flapping in the wind. Our lives in the zone of control. Inland Empire, something tells you her life and yours are not that similar. Maybe it's because she has a boat and you have that necktie? A pair of pants? Our lives are very different from each other. No doubt, but we share the same time and position on the planet's crust. That counts for more than you'd think. What is the zone of control? A city-state divided into free market zones under the everlasting interregnum of the Coalition of Nations, and you, of course, the Citizens' Militia. Esprit de Corps says, the chatter of typewriter keys fills the main hall of a reappropriated silk mill. Precinct 41. Chad Tilburg presses enter. Outside, Officer Elfboy Williams slams the door of an armored motor carriage. The zone of control is the third incarnation Revachol, after the failure of the suzerain and the commune. What happened to the rest of the world? Or in the rest of the world? Modernity. They developed the marvels of inter-isolary communication, telemetric milieus, radiation, colored plastics. Meanwhile, in Revachol West, the aftermath continues for the fifth decade. Logic says 51 minus 8 equals 43. Wait, you're saying it's been like this for 43 years? Time flies. What have we been doing all that time? The 20s saw a decade of urban war. West of the river leveled, offshore platforms in flames. Still, it's regarded as an improvement on what came before. 08 to 19 was simply hell. And after that? The 30s? Things settled down in the 30s. Revachol East transformed itself into the world's largest tax haven, with the international community's blessing. For the first time in a long time, it seemed like things were going somewhere. Were they? No, it was a market mirage, fueled by cocaine and quantitative easing. The 40s dispelled it like a cold splash, an Isola-wide hangover, you might say. And here we are, she curtsies. Task complete for getting a reality lowdown. Welcome to reality, baby. Logic says, for her to be where she is, Wild Pines Group must have picked the right side. That's enough about the times. They are what they are. Who knows? An afterbloom may yet come. I wanted to save, yeah, some stuff. But let's finish with the times, I guess. Who got the mineral rights? The liberals got the mineral rights. She looks up to the sky, then inland at the crumbling city. And by mineral rights, I mean everything. Okay, and by liberals, you mean... Liberals are usually middle-class people, Detective, or the remaining gentry, the beneficiaries of the pre-revolutionary arrangement. Some were rich enough to stay with the Constitution, with monarchy. Big mistake. Others bet on the revolution. They were called the ultras, or ultra-liberals. They fared well. How did the liberals win it all? They didn't win so much as survive. We were the last ones standing when the war ended. Everyone else got shot in the head, remember? Rhetoric says, we. She's one of them, of course. If everyone got shot, who was there to surrender to? The foreign intervention, the coalition. Those people really took the mineral rights. Wait, you just said the liberals actually already took everything. The liberals took everything that wasn't nailed to the ground. The coalition took the ground. She stomps her rubber-booted foot. The ocean, the laws, and the people. Who are the Coalition? The Coalition of Nations. Grad, Mesk, Vesper, Messina, Aranye, and Surla Clef. The armed center of the world. They landed here and ended the revolution. It was the moralist thing to do. Empathy says, there is bitterness in her voice, tempered with understanding. She is critical, but ultimately understands the cause. Moralist? The moralists believe in keeping everything exactly the way it is. They believe in mineral rights, and not shooting people in the head. And last, at least not in the same manner and volume as the others do. They are the long-standing provisional rulers of Revachol now, the coalition government. This is their zone of control. They embolden the RCM with crumbs of the same law they took. Technically speaking, you are a moralist. Encyclopedia says, the color of moralism is blue. The official motto of the Moral Intern, or Moralist International, is a blue forget-me-not, a piece of the gray sky. Unofficial, for a moment, there was hope. Not just technically, practically. For a moment, there was hope. A devout man of the center, she nods. Hard to come by. It's good to have someone who takes a moderate approach to head shooting. In your line of work, I mean. Which side was Wild Pine's group on? They picked the winning side. That's why they're here, and others are not. They chose wisely. Perhaps it wouldn't have turned out that way had I been in charge. I might have been on the king and led the pines to doom. You would have sided with the king? I would have sided with the cannons. If you'd seen the calibers of the things, you might have too, she thinks. Perhaps it's better I was born when I was. 10 of the 14 Endo tribes got it wrong. Feld, Kupri, Tricentennial. So I suppose I would have been in good company. What would you have done differently? Good question, she cranes her neck. What would you have done differently? I asked you, who are you in all this? And I asked you, past list detective of the Citizens Militia, what insight has acute encephalopathia given to you? I asked her you first. I would have sought a medical solution. Sounds like Zarath drove those people mad. So a quarter of humanity, she calculates, simply lost their minds? And how would you stop a prion? Was I saying prison the whole time and it was prion? If so, I apologize, guys. How would you stop a prion, a complex folding protein, unlife with the technology 50 years ago? With privatized healthcare and a work ethic that does not turn your brain into sponge tissue. A poor remedy for prion disease, she says. That was the attitude of most of the more moderate Indo tribes, particularly those who supported the king. Capri, Resplendent, both gone now. Those that survived mended their ways. They're all ultras now. Is that clearing his throat? Lieutenant puts down his notes for a moment. Opinions expressed here do not reflect the official position of the RCM. She turns to him. And what is your official position, Lieutenant? My position, ma'am? My parents got ripped to shreds in the revolution. I would have been gone the same way. I was saved by being 2 years old. That's my position, the abattoir. Understandable, she nods. Rhetoric says, not so fast. Who is she in all this? Ask her who she is. She owes you an answer. Okay, I wasn't supposed to ask all this. I want to know what you are. Not who you are, but what you are. She hums. What are you? I am the vilest of the vile, she says with a sudden flash of teeth. A traitor, a devourer of nations and infants. I am an ultra. Wait, what's an ultra? An ultra-liberal. It's a type of liberal from the revolution. It's not the moderate kind. I don't understand. What's so vile about that? Haven't you heard? She nods pedagogically. How do you nod pedagogically? I am a nether creature of the Forbidden Swamp, one of those who pushed the king under a crap wagon and betrayed the revolution. We surrendered the nation to financier pirates. No sane person identifies an ultra-liberal anymore. As an ultra-liberal anymore, and not in broad daylight. She looks into your eye. I can tell we're not so different, you know. Tell me, now that I've uncoiled myself, do you find me frightening? Empathy says, in her green eyes you see a mixture of truth and self-satire, decades of guilt and pride. I don't care. A fitting punishment, she smirks, to be forgotten, if not forgiven. Save a prayer for us in the chateaus on Ozon and in Stella Maris. When the dust settled, the liberals were the only ones left to clean up the mess. By virtue of their survival, they were handed enormous power to shape the future. She turns her gaze to the Delta. This was all our last generation managed. Would you have done something differently? With the due respect to our overlords, the eternal caretaker government that keeps Martinez a monument to the efficacy of its artillery, I would not have relinquished sovereignty to the Coalition. Not here in Martinez, and not in the Stella Maris or Delta Beachheads either. If not for my own sake, then for my daughter's. We had an obligation to defend our sovereignty. We should have burned the whole Isola down rather than let them have it. Inland Empire says, dark orange flames reflect in her green eyes. An oil fire on the ocean. You're a smart woman. Perhaps. Her earrings chime as she nods. My intellectual vanity will be my undoing. Logic says, you're no dummy yourself. So am I. A smart boy getting smarter. One basic term of reality at a time. You're a patriot? Yes, I suppose I am. But I wouldn't be a patriot anywhere but here. Seditious talk, ma'am. Kim puts down the notes and gives her a look. You have daughters? Yes, whatever else I am, I'm also a mother. And a wife. She closes her eyes, then reopens them again. Now, shall we return to reality? Yes, Kim wanted me to save some of this for later. That's all for now. Glad to have been of assistance, the little that I know. Anything else? Yeah, tell me about this alleged drug trafficking. It's quite straightforward. Someone is using Terminal B to smuggle raw ingredients from the Samaran Isola into Revachol with the Union's blessing. Wild Pines has suspected it for years. Kim says, ingredients for what, ma'am? Meth and dextroamphetamine, GBL and various synthetic psychedelics. Honestly, it might be quicker to say with what you can't make from the stuff. Let me get this straight. The materials come from Samara to Revachol through the terminal? Yes. After they clear the terminal, we lose track. The actual production is taking place at various sites in and around Jamrock Quarter, north of here. Kim says, Wild Pines seem to be well apprised of the local drug trade, ma'am. Do you mean to say the Union also produces the product? Sells drugs, I mean? We're in logistics. It's our business to know. And no, as far as the company knows, the Union does not produce it. They transport the ingredients for a cut. And you want us to investigate? Yes, but you won't get anything out of Everard and the Dock Workers Union. Still, she raises her bony finger, every chain has its weak link. Logic says, the handoff. The motor lorries at the roundabout. Okay. The lorries. Precisely. Someone needs to move the ingredients from the harbor into the city. Once they reach Jamrock, they're distributed to a network of local manufacturers. Well beyond our grasp. But in transit, they are vulnerable. Visual calculus says how convenient that they're stranded like beached whales at the roundabout. Perhaps you've noticed that a number of lorries are tangled in a traffic jam at the roundabout just now. Interview the drivers who are still hanging about. One of them might be waiting for a crucial shipment. She gives you a knowing look. Yeah, I think I know who to talk to. I'll be explicit. If you find this driver, I will share company secrets with you. Logic says, uncovering union secrets could also give you an upper hand when dealing with them. This is a long conversation, guys. It's no coincidence the lorries are stranded there like that, is it? No, we asked East Motor Track to raise the drawbridge. The road company is a partner of one of our subsidiaries. However, she pauses, looking to the sea, this is a limited time opportunity. Once a complaint has been processed by the trade committee, they'll have no choice but to lower the drawbridge, and the operation will continue. She looks north. Thousands of liters of raw ingredients will pour onto the streets of Revachol. Not the east across the river, but the west. The vulnerable. The weary. Kim says, well, at least this solves one mystery. What is that, Lieutenant? Why I had to call East Motor Tract and beg them to open a drawbridge for me. I'd wondered since I first drove in on my motor carriage. I am sorry for the inconvenience, Lieutenant Katsuragi, but we need them trapped here. This is a unique opportunity. I'm sure you understand. Why didn't you come to the RCM earlier? We did, on more than one occasion. Apparently there's some sort of inter-precinct disagreement about whose jurisdiction this area falls under. Kim says, we know the company has launched its own probe into the union's alleged involvement. We also know it's come up empty. It's not just the RCM. No one's been able to find any hard evidence. Well, she smiles and points toward the roundabout. Here's your chance, officers. What proof do you have that the union is involved? How do you think they're financing this strike? There are thousands of unpaid dock workers going strong for the fourth month straight. Kim says there was a shakedown of local businesses operating the strike. Many were squeezed to bankruptcy to fund it. With all due respect to these desert cacti, the contents of a few cash registers cannot provide for 2,000 men. The local businesses can scarcely provide for themselves. So you think the strike is being funded with source ingredients for drugs? Precisely. Smuggled out of that very gate at night, most likely, then loaded onto lorries and driven to Jamrock, you simply need to find one driver who will open up to you. We already have some suspicions that one of the drivers was present at the lynching. The two might even be connected. Or not, Kim says. Though if you have evidence to the contrary, I'm eager to hear it. As eager as I am to share it, Lieutenant, once the job is done. Okay, I've made up my mind about the smuggling investigation. Yes? We will take this case, probe the drivers, see what it yields. Excellent. She takes a long sip of tea. According to my reports, there are at least three lorry drivers lingering near the roundabout. Hopefully one of them will know something. It may come to nothing, or it may just blow the case wide open. I can keep the drawbridge up for a few more days at least. You should have the time you need. Okay, good. I have a few days, because I'm still looking around, exploring. In the meantime, let me know if there's any other way I may be of assistance. She takes another long sip from her seemingly bottomless thermal cup. Thank you. That's all for now. Of course, Detective. Take care. Wow. Okay. So we can level up. What should we level up? Volition? What do we... Authority. If I level up authority, I can try to, you know, extend my authority over the Hardy boys again. We have pretty good authority now. The Jam Mystery. Someone's using Terminal B to smuggle raw ingredients of drugs into Revachol. Joyce said there are three drivers at the intersection. Talk to them. One of them must know something about the drug trade. Interrogate the drivers about the smuggling. And now we have another thing in our thought cabinet. Jamais vu. I don't know. Derealization. Temporary research bonus is none, but at least it's not a negative. Revachol's special administrative region, Le
Likalu, the Insulindian Ocean Coalition Government Insulindian Mission Command. Name after name, and none of them is familiar. They seem real, but something is wrong. You feel like a kid looking at the stickers on the fridge. Juvant, the Apricot Company, World Games 34. You can almost see your hand reaching out for them. Scratch at the corners, see if they peel loose. This feels like the most important of all the thoughts, the one you truly must complete. Then let's do so. Just over 3 hours to go, and it will be complete. Okay, well, we're going to look around some more before we talk to these lorry drivers. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.